members of foreign consulates, overseas agent secretary. Please give a big hand to Zui Chawla. Mr. Gadkari has come. Please give him a big hand. Mr. Gadkari is here.
कर रहा हूँ यार, रुकेगा।
Distinguished, I think Niranjan Hira Nandani will speak after me, and I'll continue. Members of advisory committee, ladies and gentlemen, I am extremely happy and overwhelmed to see all of you assembled here for Priyadarshini Academy 32nd Anniversary Global Award Function. Our chief guest and special guest of honors have been very kind to us and have associated with the Academy for many, many years. And they have always been a great source of inspiration and strength to us. Nitin Gadkari is a very, very dear friend. I am fortunate to be his friend. I was introduced to him by late Shri Balasaheb Thackeray, who was a very dear friend of us. But I would say that he and I have some relation in the past life. Gadkari ji, some relation in the past life. Whenever I have asked him to come to present here, know that he is doing a commendable job by building roads, ports and other infrastructure projects at a super jet speed. I don't think any minister in past has reached the speed what he has. Earlier it was 3 kilometers a day, now it is 22 kilometers, new roads are made every day. I had an opportunity to travel with him to Japan, Hong Kong, Singapore, Malaysia, and there I admired him. He said, I want to do something here, just become a minister. And after that I have seen whatever he touched turns into a goal. I do not know how many hours he keeps for himself and how many hours he gives to sleep. We just went to see him in Delhi. He said, come on, have a breakfast with me. And at the same time, when he was a breakfast, he was also preparing for question answers. All the secretaries were around him. So how he managed the time, he can do 10 things at a time. Really, a very rare person of Gadkari ji. He taught us to dream big, think big, do big. We would have never reached to the prime ministers and presidents of different countries who have been awarded it only because of him. Last time when the Japanese Prime Minister was selected, he said he will not be there and you have to be in Delhi to give him an award. We were really, you know, I was saying, oh my God, how the Prime Minister of Japan will meet us. But when we mentioned Suresh Prabhu, he said, no, you are welcome. So this is the goodwill he is enjoying. I am sure he will do wonders in railways. It is only because of foresight and his confidence he has built in us. He is an unassuming, down to earth, but man with a golden heart. I have no words to thank him. Suresh, I think in future also, on this day he will always be with us. Please give him a hand. Priyadarshini Academy Awards were instituted to recognize individuals from outstanding contribution in different fields. The service rendered by them cannot be described in words. The Academy is very proud honoring these luminaries all these years. Mr. Anshu Gupta, Dr. A.S. Kiran Kumar, Katrina Kaif will be joining us very soon. Juhi Chawla, Dr. Venki Ramakrishnan, Dr. Frank Richter, and Dr. Uri Shani. All the awardees have done marvelous work and exemplary service to humanity and society in respective fields of activities. They have brightened many lives and brought changes in India and abroad. Dr. Mashalkar, the chairman, and his team of members of Global Awards Committee have put in tremendous effort in identifying and selecting these individuals in their chosen field. I am sure my daughter Reena Rupani will do full justice in introducing them. They have honored us by accepting our awards, and all of them are institutions by themselves.
Unstoppable and unbeatable Nitin Gadkari, the man who took up the road network of India, who took up the Mountain Pune Road as a challenge, and today took it up to say, should we make 10 kilometers of national highways per day? National highways, we are talking the width of Mountain Pune Road. He said, no, it should be doubled. And so he put the target as 20 kilometers of national highway per day. Sorry, he is not stopping there. His target for this year and next year is 30 kilometers of national highways per day. He is unstoppable, but he stops to come to Priyadarshini Academy. Thank you very much. May you be unstoppable in ports, highways and other things. God bless you, sir. With the leadership that we have, we will make a paradigm of infrastructure in India, which will beat not only the rest of the world, but also China, whom we look up to in terms of being the fastest infrastructure developer in the world. Sir, we wish you best of luck, and to the Prime Minister for having chosen you. Thank you very much for being with Priyadarshini and a part of this infrastructure. Mr. Suresh Prabhu doesn't want to be left behind. He loves our academy, he loves IMC, where we were being together, and he has blessed us, wished us, and been participated in his own amicable way, and he has done it with a flourish. The railways always had a problem because they subsidized all the railway lines. The tickets of Mumbai in terms of railway passes only cover 5% of the cost of the railways. But he doesn't say a stop over there. He's going to double the tracks, increase the number of bogies, help for the metro lines, do other things. But he said, where will the money come from? You know, it's not possible just to print notes. Of course, the government can do it, but he doesn't. So what has he done? He has now raised 150,000 crores to add the railways in the next 24 months, which will take from the Life Insurance Corporation of India, which will make a paradigm of the railways, which will increase by leaps and bounds. He's not happy over there. He says that's not enough to increase the railways. So he says the Prime Minister may make Swachh Bharat, but I will make Swachh Railways. And so he wants to make the cleanest railways of all, and has started to clean up the railway tracks, the railway areas, the railway boogies, and the railway station. Sir, thank you very much for being with us and being that wonderful minister which will make Mumbai, Maharashtra, better in terms of connectivity, but the whole of India, and not only that, the bullet train to go from Mumbai to Ahmedabad in a shortest period of time of a couple of hours. Thank you very much for being with us and being the wonderful Minister of Railways that he is over here today. Ladies and gentlemen, what should I say? So many lovely people over here, but I must first tell you Nanik Rupani. Nanik Rupani created this institution and it is a part of his blood. And he keeps on saying that I've taken it over. I hope so in the next couple of years I will be fit enough to take over that post. But thank you, Mr. Rupani, for being that wonderful person that you are, and in terms of doing whatever it is, and he continues to do much more than he is. And he is deservedly called Chairman Emeritus, but his Emeritus name is more current than what is supposed to be normally under the English definition. Thank you, Rupani, for being that great leadership that you have shown. I want to say certain things about a few of the recipients that I have, but that's not a starting point. The starting point is my guru and teacher, Dr. Mashalkar. A scientist of repute, a person who was chosen by the government to lead the technology of India, making that paradigm feel that the benefits of that should reach the common man and make that technology happen. So he talks about not only the technology of India, but how can it reach the common man, and has now had 1 lakh people being skill trained under his NGO. So he is not just a technologist, he is a man of the grassroots, he touches the hearts of people but gives jobs to a lakh of people every year. Sir, thank you for being our leader and choosing the right person and being the chairman of our institution that we have. His leadership is second to none, and if the good people have been chosen over here, it is because of his kindness and leadership that he shows and the bestowing of knowledge that we have. There are a lot of other people. But I want to start with somebody who is very special, who does water. Mumbai has either floods or it is dry. Maharashtra, is it flood or it is dry? India, is it flood or dry? And in some areas it's flood, and in some areas it's dry. But in a place of desert called Israel, there is sufficient water. And why is there sufficient water in the desert of Israel? It is due to a person called Dr. Uri Shani. Thank you very much for being an award winner, which makes this paradigm happen for Israel. Brought in new technologies, brought a relationship between three countries, Jerusalem, Israel, and Jordan, otherwise enemies. But they have a relationship to provide water in the region. And that is because of this great man who's being awarded today. Congratulations, sir, and thank you very much for taking the time of coming over here. We have Dr. Frank Rater, a man who believes that relationship, building trust and dialogue between countries make a lot of difference. Globalization is a part of his blood. He has brought about relationships of creating business interests, globalization to bring benefits to the common man. Recently, we had the opportunity of going to Portugal under his leadership.
I'm sure we can support many of the members. Present a welcome bouquet to our guest of honor, Mr. Suresh Prabhu. We're going to connect with Mr. Piyush Goyal in a little while. May I request Mr. Hiranathani and Mr. Rupani once again to present a welcome bouquet to our special invitee on stage, Ms. Afreen Rachel Wals. We have some very special invitees in the audience with us today, and we'd like to acknowledge their presence and thank them for being here. May I request somebody from the Academy to present a bouquet to Mr. Ashish Shelar from the BJP. Yes, okay, all right. Our very own Miss Poonam Dhillon is here. She has been an Indian. Thank you, Poonam, so much for being with us.
Still, blue shirt. यार क्या कर रहे हैं यार हम लोग। Still. अरे यार
Recent successful launches of the RLV TV and the GSLV Mark II using homegrown cryogenic rocket technology, and the record launch of 20 satellites in 26 minutes in a single mission are only some of its many other accomplishments. ISRO has successfully launched satellites for over 20 countries, including USA, UK, Germany, Israel, Japan, and France. Often described as NASA's envy, India's pride, ISRO is held in the highest esteem across the world. We are delighted to have the chairman of ISRO, Dr. A.S. Kiran Kumar, with us today. A Padma Shri recipient, he is the man at ISRO's helm and has played a crucial role in several of its successful space missions. I'd like to request Mr. Nitin Gadkari to present the Priyadarshini Academy Global Award for Outstanding Contribution to Space Science and Technology to ISRO. And I'd like to request Dr. Kiran Kumar to receive this award. Dr. Kiran Kumar, may I request you to address the audience, please?
Good afternoon to all of you. Mr. Nitin Gadkari, Honorable Minister for Shipping and Road Transport, Mr. Suresh Prabhu, Honorable Minister for Railways, Mashelkar, and Priyadarshini Academy, and all of you who have gathered here today on this wonderful occasion where an academy for 32nd time is recognizing people for their contribution to the society, not only in our country, but also across the globe. On behalf of Indian Space Research Organization, I deem it a great honor to accept this recognition the country is giving to our organization. Indian Space Research Organization, right from its inception, has started looking at availability of a new technology of space, how to make use of this for benefiting the country's growth and development. It is the vision of people like Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, who saw in this space technology a means by which we can bring in rapid development by communication, revolution in communication, and bringing in observation from space, where today we are in a position to warn at least 48 hours in advance on the impending cyclones which can reach the coastal regions. Today we have a capability to tell the country at least 48 hours in advance with an error less than 20 kilometers in space and half an hour in time. Just recently we also launched an INSAT 3D satellite which is capable of providing additional information, and this was launched using an indigenous cryo engine and third one in consecutive successful mission. You can realize that this technology, by virtue of its nature, information is not easy to get. It is the dedicated efforts of scientists and technologists in Indian Space Research Organization, which has worked as a team.
And Comet Timing comes second only to her irresistible million-dollar smile. As a humanitarian, Julie has been associated with a number of charities and social causes. She is very committed to spreading awareness about thalassemia and to providing education for special children. She is actively working on improving the current educational system by reducing the heavy workload on children. For several years now, Julie has been on a mission to educate people about the health hazards of mobile phone and tower antenna radiation. She has been visiting schools, speaking at seminars, working with citizens groups and calling on ministers and authorities to drive her point home. Last year, she received the Indira Gandhi Memorial Award for Social Awareness for her active participation and selfless effort towards this cause. Yes, you may blame her for some of the call drops, as Mr. Hiranandani said, but in recognition of her outstanding contribution to social causes, I'd like to request Mr. Suresh Prabhu to present the Priyadarshini Academy Global Award to Ms. Juhi Chawla.
Dancing and singing around trees, that's what I've done. What am I doing with this issue. Like I said, I didn't choose radiation. Radiation chose me. Perhaps it needed a simple person to be able to explain this very complex, abstract kind of topic to the common people in a simple way. For this, for all that I have done these years, or managed to do, I would say, I want to thank my team, without whose support and whose unstinted help, I could not have made it this far. It is Sejal, Nirima, and my very helpful neighbor, Mr. Prakash Munshi. He's here with me today. I dragged him for this. I said, I could not have achieved this had it not been for his unstinted support. A few weeks ago, I was at our Gurukul in Porbandar, and I heard this on stage. I found it so amazing, I wanted to share it with you. Soch badlo, sitare badal jayenge. Soch badlo, sitare badal jayenge. Nazar badlo, nazare badal jayenge. Kashtiyan badalne ki zarurat nahi hai doston. Kashtiyan badalne ki zarurat nahi hai doston. दिशा बदलो किनारे बदल जाएंगे.
Numerous positions in the government of India with delivered milestones.
He is affiliated with a large number of national and global organizations and has also served as a senior advisor to the United Nations. In his current role as Union Railways Minister, he has brought in a variety of passenger-friendly reforms in the railways. Tweet a problem or complaint and you get a prompt reply from the Indian Railways. Bullet trains to reduce travel times, increased number of coaches to accommodate more people, Wi-Fi connectivity at more than 400 stations.
Can you decide about what has happened? We already, at the beginning of the program, opened a controller. Here is an academy. It has been doing a great job for so many years. Today we are given awards to people who excel in science, technology, agriculture, different kinds of art, and many others. Mr. Nanik Rupani, and now some years, and Mr. Niranjan, and a great scientist, Dr. Masekar and his team, have been doing this great job. Being a part of this process myself for a long time, can I make a suggestion that we should also think about an award for someone who fights terrorism, which would be the most appropriate way to come up with someone who is working a great job globally and make sure that everybody can live in peace. I think when the first peace award was announced by Nobel Prize Committee, they would have probably even comprehended or would have imagined that what the peace would really mean and how people would destroy peace. So I think we really need to institute such an award to the national this. Let me once again congratulate all of you for the great advantage of being in the seat of power is that you can also give an award to someone for whom you have been worshipping and as a fan. So I think it's also great opportunity to give an award to such a person. So Nanik Rupani must be complimented because he has been thinking of these global awards much before India opened up the economy in 1991. So he's been even I would say the real harbinger of global
admiration of millions of film goers around the world. She dances like a dream and has some sizzling chartbuster numbers like Sheela Ki Jawani, Chikni Chameli, and Kala Chashma to her credit. Forbes has listed her in their top 10 list of India's best known entertainers. And last year, her wax statue was installed at Madame Tussauds in London. In recognition for being one of the most successful and popular Bollywood actors, and for a string of successes which rank among the highest grossers at the box office, may I request Mr. Nitin Gadkari to present the Smita Patil Memorial Award to Mr.
Madam.
Katrina, over to you.
sitting alongside this afternoon. Thank you very much for the honor of inviting me here. I'm very happy to be here. There's just a few things that I would like to say. Firstly, I believe the world of cinema, not only Indian cinema, is often called a man's world. It is changing, but the change is slow. So I believe it's a matter of great pride that we have an award that acknowledges and recognizes the contribution of women to cinema. This award honors the memory of one of the greatest and the most accomplished actors, whose role served as an inspiration in the lives of millions of women. As an actor, the love of the people is the biggest reward of all. But when there is recognition from the industry in the form of an award, for me it's very overwhelming. I believe the most important thing in art is truth, and I can promise that my attempt is truthful and sincere to the craft, which has largely given me my purpose in life over the last few years. The one thing I do hope is that I can continue to make the audience who has given me so much love and support over these last few years, I hope that I can continue to make them proud of me and to deserve their support and their love as they have always given me. I'd like to thank the jury for this recognition, and I'd like to accept this award on behalf of every woman who seeks to excel in her field of work. I read something very interesting that I thought was very beautiful. It is said that women hold up half the sky, and I think it is women like Smita Ji who show us that not even the sky is the limit. So I'd like to thank you all very much for this award, and it's a pleasure being here this afternoon.
All the very best for your upcoming films, and may you continue to entertain people around the world with all your wonderful performances. I mentioned earlier we have a very special invitee with us today. As winner of Campus Princess 2015 pageant, Ms. Afreen Rachel Vaz got a direct entry into Femina Miss India 2015.
Ladies and gentlemen, and entries on the dais. I feel really overwhelmed standing here and talking to you after such wonderful people have just spoken such wonderful things. I want to share a story with you which I think many people are aware of, but I found it interesting. In 1984, a very accomplished and talented Kathak dancer, Miss Anila Sundar, I think the name was, really wanted to showcase her talent to the world. Unfortunately, she wasn't from the most fortunate backgrounds and did not know how to go about showing this talent to the world. And at that time, she came across a group of people, like-minded individuals, who approached Mr. Rupani. And what followed was a series of discussions and meetings which resulted in the Priyadarshini Academy. I think I represent the population that benefit from this academy. I did win a national title and I went on to win the international title. However, I believe that first and foremost, I'm a student of medicine and surgery, a student of classical dance, and a student of Hindustani theater. So when I stand here, I'm trembling because I'm a student of those things that these wonderful gentlemen and women have become a master of. Priyadarshini Academy allows people like me, my brothers and sisters of various fraternities, to become successful. And the quote that was said earlier today, just a little bit earlier than me, that success is our birthright, not just a monopoly of few, is the very quote that Priyadarshini Academy stands for. And it's an academy which is holistic in the way that its scholarships benefit us as academics, but also recognize artists and recognize people that are trying to make a difference and contribute in a way that is immense and permanent. And for the honor that Priyadarshini Academy has invited me to be here and to be part of such a wonderful dais, all I want to say is if I could have a time machine and I went back to Poland where I was representing India and the international jury asked me, Miss India, You say that India is a great nation. What makes it so great? Oh, I had a wonderfully rehearsed answer, thanks to Mr. Veera Merchant, who's a brilliant teacher. But if that was to happen again, I would say, look to my left. These are my countrymen. Get to know them, and you will get to know my country. Thank you.
उस समय उसके पहले हमारे उस समय के मुख्यमंत्री मनोहर जोशी और मैं कुछ लोग विदेश पति गए थे, नानी में भी हमारे साथ थे, हम इंडोनेशिया, सिंगापुर, मलेशिया, जापान अनेक देशों में गए थे और उनके बहुत इंटरनेशनल कनेक्शन अच्छे थे। महाराष्ट्र के लिए इन्वेस्टमेंट के लिए उन्होंने बहुत कोशिश की और इसलिए स्वाभाविक रूप से एक अच्छे सोशल वर्कर और एजुकेशन और सोशल वर्क की इसमें अच्छा काम करने वाले सामाजिक कार्यकर्ता के रूप में उनका परिचय पूरे देश को है। और मुझे इस बात की खुशी है कि लगातार प्रियदर्शनी अकेडमी की ओर से जो भी ऐसे टैलेंटेड लोग हैं जो पूरे वर्ल्ड के अच्छे अच्छे काम करने वाले साइंटिस्ट हैं, फिल्मों में काम करने वाले कलाकार हैं, साहित्यिक हैं, पत्रकार हैं या पॉलिटिशियन हैं, जो भी अच्छा टैलेंट है उसको रिकॉग्नाइज करना ये काम अकेडमी ने हर समय किया है। और ये केवल 2-5 साल चल के ये कार्यक्रम खत्म नहीं हुआ, अनेक सालों से ये कार्यक्रम चल रहा है और आगे भी इसी प्रकार से चलता रहेगा, ये मेरा विश्वास है। आज के इस समारोह में बहुत ही समाज में जिन्होंने अच्छा काम किया है ऐसे सभी व्यक्तियों को गौरवान्वित किया गया है और निश्चित रूप से जिन्होंने अच्छा काम किया है इसका सबसे फायदा यही होता है कि जो लोग उनके कार्य की तरफ देखते हैं तो उनको लगता है हमने भी ऐसा कुछ करना चाहिए, ये हमने भी ऐसा कुछ करना चाहिए, ये इंस्पायरेशन है, मोटिवेशन है, ये बहुत बड़ी बात है। और समाज में जब सोशल इकोनॉमिक रिफॉर्म होगा, क्वालिटेटिव रिफॉर्म होगा, तो समाज में कितने लोग अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं इसी के आधार पर होगा। और ऐसे गुणात्मक परिवर्तन के लिए लगातार ऐसे अच्छे कार्य करने वाले लोगों को गौरवान्वित करना और ऐसे अच्छे कार्य करने वाले लोगों की संख्या बढ़ाने से ही हमारा समाज और देश और मजबूत होने वाला है। प्रियदर्शनी अकादमी का ये कार्य आगे भी ऐसे ही चलता रहेगा और जो ऐसे टैलेंटेड लोग हैं उनको गौरवान्वित करता रहेगा, ये मेरा विश्वास है। आज के इस समारोह में जिन लोगों को विशेष रूप से गौरवान्वित किया गया है वो बहुत अच्छा कार्य उन्होंने अपने क्षेत्र में किया है, उनको सबकी उज्ज्वल भविष्य की कामना करते हुए मैं अपने तरफ से उनको बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं और शुभेच्छा देता हूँ। और प्रियदर्शन अकादमी को ये कार्यक्रम आयोजन हर साल करके ये जो रिकग्निशन रिस्पेक्ट जो ये अच्छे लोगों को देते हैं इसके लिए उनके प्रति धन्यवाद देकर मैं अपनी बात को समाप्त करता हूँ। धन्यवाद।
For more news and gossip, don't forget to subscribe to Bollywood Helpline.